Welcome back. As we've been telling you all morning, we're excited to introduce a brand new way for you, the viewer, to interact with the show here on Squawk Alley. It gives you a chance to vote on some of the many topics that we talk about in real time. So indeed, the voting is starting right now. Head to cnbc.com/vote. You want to do this on your computer or on any mobile device. Let your voice be heard, and we'll show you the results as they happen. And joining us this morning for all of this, Jessica Lessen, formerly a tech reporter at the Wall Street Journal, now founder and editor-in-chief at The Information. Julia Borson is in the house as well. Welcome to you both. And let's get right to it. Let's start with Amazon. Will the online giant reveal a 3D smartphone today? So this is the question. Go cnbc.com/vote and let us know your thoughts on it. Jeff Bezos expected to take the stage in just a couple of hours for the big reveal. Again, we expect it's a phone, and we're asking you, the viewers, to sound off on cnbc.com/vote. Tell us, would you buy the Amazon phone? Jessica, what do you think about this initiative?
Well, it's just been in the works for so many years. I mean, Amazon has been at this for a while. I think it's exciting what they're going to come out with. We know the specs. They always get leaked, seem pretty standard. But, you know, it's hard to really see this moving the needle. I mean, if you look at Kindle sales, Kindle Fire sales, you're talking small market share. And, you know, I think that the burden's really on them, and I think it'll be cool to see what happens, but not predicting a game changer.
Roger McNamee echoed that this morning, Jessica.
Yeah, I think it's really interesting that this comes a week after the announcement of Amazon Music, which is yet another content play trying to expand the benefits of Amazon Prime. So Amazon wants to keep people in its ecosystem, listening to music, buying games, and they're trying to do that with the Kindle Fire. They're also obviously going to try to do it with a phone. And I think it's just really interesting the amount they're willing to invest in content, even as they face off with those content owners like Hachette or Warner Brothers, who are pushing back about those rights that Amazon is looking for at costs that the content owners think aren't high enough.
The 3D technology thing is what I'm really, really looking forward to seeing how this actually works, because it just doesn't seem like something that we, the consumer, would need. I mean, it sounds from descriptions by people like Brad Stone, who, of course, wrote the book on Amazon, that it's something like Nintendo Wii. You can play games, you can make calls, you can do things without actually touching the screen of your phone. People, when certain voice recognition apps came out, they said, well, who's really going to use it? And, in fact, a lot of people did. I'm wondering the same thing about this 3D technology. What exactly does it do? What can you do with it?
John, I remember.
And will be eye tracking. Samsung released eye tracking technology, you know, great for selling sort of TV ads to have some cool footage. Not sure how practical it is.
And John, a couple things this could do. It could give Amazon information about how people are using the product. Amazon's investing in gaming. It can be used there to differentiate the platform and, of course, looking at products.
All right, we've been watching this bounce around at the bottom of the screen. The voting is now closed, so here's what you think about forking out for an Amazon smartphone. 57% are saying no. 43% are saying yes. We'll see if that changes after Amazon actually announces the details. Our next question, whose products do you trust more, Apple's or Amazon's? This is an interesting one. Apple versus Amazon, Jessica, is this the essence of the of what the Amazon phone is all about? Or is it? Are they sort of after two different objectives, ultimately?
I think that question is something we should have Amazon answer, because I think it's a big question shareholders have. You know, I think Julia talking about services are more important to Amazon's business. Apple is a hardware company. But we've got this overlap as hardware commoditizes in software. And one thing I think is going to be very interesting to look out for in the Amazon phone, it's not just the Amazon services, but what do they do for maps? What do they do for search? What do they do for that stuff that other, you know, since this is sort of a forked Android phone, it's probably not going to have the Google services that are best of breed. If Amazon can't get those right, it's a no starter.
But I mean, it's probably going to look like a Microsoft Windows phone, right? Because they're using Bing, they're using Nokia Maps. That's likely to be the maps and services.
What is Nokia Apps?
Nokia Maps.
Oh,
Nokia
maps.
Actually has Here. It's a mapping technology that Microsoft uses. Not bad. I mean, it's serviceable. It'll be interesting to see if Amazon's customer
Here's
base
an interesting thing. Can I just draw everyone's attention to what's happening right now? 2-1, Amazon is beating Apple in terms of whose products you trust more. Julie, does that surprise you?
That's really surprising to me. I mean, I think about all the Apple products I own. You know, in our household, there are a ton of iPhones. There are iPhone touches that there are old devices we've repurposed for other things. There are iPads. We have an Apple TV. And I think about the only Amazon device that we own is a Kindle. And I don't have a Fire tablet. And I feel like the people I know mostly have a Kindle, but then they also use the Kindle app on their iPad. I think a lot of people are used to buying things through Amazon, reading books through Amazon, but don't think of it as a device company.
You also become acutely aware when Amazon is tracking you. I had them match a price on Walmart by just going back to the site, and I thought, wow, they're following me everywhere around the internet.
Yes, lest there was any doubt. And yet, if we can take a look at what's happening with the voting, it still seems as though, by quite a wide margin, the vote was for Amazon instead of
Apple. I think Apple, didn't Apple come from behind there in the voting?
Perhaps.
Am I wrong?
Can we show it, Joshua? All right, no, we're moving on. Next, you may have noticed the Apple Store was down this morning. It turns out the company was pulling a Beyonce. It was quietly launching a new product on the website with little fanfare. Indeed, it was a cheaper iMac. So we want to know, sound off, cnbc.com/vote, whose stealth launch was better, Beyonce's or Apple? Oh, Jessica.
I'm sorry, Beyonce, hands down. I mean, the thing that Apple's stealth launches are when the products are just kind of eh. Now, not to say that, I mean, a cheaper iMac is a great product, but, you know, in Apple, you have the extreme fanfare and then the sort of everything else for what doesn't
beat
that bar.
But isn't there a question about whether the cheaper iMac really is a great product? I mean, it sounds like it has less storage and it's just not going to be as fast as the higher priced iMac. And if it's a $200 difference, are those customers going to be willing to pay a little bit more for a little bit more
storage? You always got to have the bottom-end product to get people in the door. A lot of people are going for the lower-end PC products. It's got a half a terabyte of storage, a little bit weaker graphics, but the bargain hunters are going to find this. I think that's why Apple didn't.
Is it cheap enough to get the bargain hunters in the door?
It is for a desktop
thing, right? So Apple does the cheaper iPhone.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's interesting. Tim Cook at WWDC, you know, he loves his Mac stats, and he loves to show that Apple's growing market share in PC when the rest of the market isn't. And, you know, at Apple's sold, I think they've sold 80 million Macs to date, and they sold 43 million iPhones last quarter.
Wow.
So it's hard to get, you know, again, I think it's a cool product, but certainly not what Apple shareholders want to see.
They're not actually trying to pull a Beyonce, exactly.
We talk often about the demise of the PC and the demise of the desktop. The fact that, you know, the upscale Apple brand now has to cater to the lower-end consumer in the desktop space and is doing so with no fanfare whatsoever, does that basically mean that, you know, that this is going to be a no fanfare space going?
No, Mac Mini, they've always catered to this segment, and they launch it quietly, and they do.
They do launch things quietly. They do new iPad updates quietly.
That's also true. Here, the voting is closed, so here's what you guys ultimately had to say about this one. Sorry, B. Apple gets 57% to Beyonce's 43%.
And Apple
that
beat Amazon
launch.
On the last question, let the record
did they?
Show. They
did. Thank you very much, intrepid reporter John Fort, for us. Jessica Lessen, such a pleasure.
Thanks for having
thank
me.
You for riding along, especially as we work out this new voting thing, but it's kind of fun.
Interactive TV.
Yes, we finally got there. Up next, speaking of interactive TV, set your DVRs. Our exclusive Snapchat from the CEO of Snapchat is coming up. But first, Rick Santelli, what, sir, are you watching this morning?